Today we're listening to Harry Styles for the first time. Let's do it. Harry Styles, like my hairstyle. I need a haircut. That's what I do. So I haven't listened to much Harry Styles at all. The extent of my knowledge is like Watermelon Sugar, and he was in One Direction. And I actually like One Direction, but who knows about his solo music? Apparently you do. You know about it. He's very famous. I've definitely heard some audios of him going around on TikTok. For some reason, my TikTok For You page just gives me Harry Styles, like, live videos, which is weird because I haven't liked any of them and I haven't listened to him at all. So I don't know why TikTok thinks I'm such a big Harry Styles fan, but now we have good old Spotify open right here. And so we're just gonna do Harry Styles. Oh, I know As It Was as well. I do know that one. So we're gonna do the top five songs from here that I don't know. So we're gonna skip As It Was and Watermelon Sugar. But before we get into it, remember to subscribe with the big bright red button below. And let's listen to some Mr. Styles. There he is, looking all smiley, big old scrunkly hair. Haircut. All right, so we're gonna start with the song Late Night Talking. Let's listen to it. 500 million streams. I feel like I should know these songs, but I don't. I'm very out of the loop, as they say. I've been living under a rock. Let's listen to Late Night Talking. Okay, I feel like I recognize this intro, but we'll see. Things haven't been quite the same. All right, funky bass line. I like these synths as well. I feel like his voice is different on this song than usual. Or am I just tripping? Who am I to judge? This album cover is also cool. I like it. Reminds me of Upside Down by Set It Off. Okay. Weird vocal effects. The harmonies, nice. Oh yeah. Now that's one of them funk melodies in the vocals. It's very common in like funkier pop music. All right, short and sweet. Yeah, it was pretty good. Synths are high quality. The vocals are nice. The melodies are pretty good, especially that late night talking. I'm not a singer, but that part, I really like that one a lot. The bass is groovy as hell. I love when they have like a syncopated bass line, but the drums are just going boom, coo. You know, but the bass line is doing some more intricate stuff. That's fun. But yeah, other than that, pretty solid. Nothing too special, but pretty good. Also, this video is definitely not going to get monetized. So if you want to maybe leave a like right now, that would be great. Thank you very much. So next song would be Watermelon Sugar, but I already know that one. So more like Watermelon Sugar Bye. am I right? Next song is Adore You. Let's hear how that one sounds. And that one has a billion views. So it's weird that I don't know these songs. All right, here we go. This is from a different album. Okay. All right, got more of that funky bass stuff going on. And again, the weird vocal effects. Seems to be very popular now. Okay, that was a good vocal. Oh. I like this chorus. I like the guitar. That's fun. Yeah, his vocals in this. I feel like these vocals are way better than the other song. Ooh, that was a good transition. The harmonies, yeah. This melody is good as well. Yeah. Alright. I like this chorus. It's very laid back, but still high energy. Makes you want to vibe out. It's a summer jam, you know? Mixing is very good. There's not too much going on, but it's all balanced very evenly. Oh, guitar solo? Not what I expected. That's cool. All right. That was so good. Okay. Got the high, low pass. Got the classic making it chill before the last chorus, so it's more powerful. Yeah, could definitely see myself listening to this and cleaning the house or something, you know? Guitar coming back in. Love me a good instrumental outro, you know? That was very good. I definitely like that one a lot more. That one was really good. I really liked the drums in that one. They were like simple, but also kind of like more intricate than the last one. The guitars in this are phenomenal. I'm gonna look up who played those guitars. Who played the guitars in Adore You by Harry Styles? Kid Harpoon. So he did the production and the everything basically in this song. Good job to you, Kid Harpoon. That's a good song. I like that. So this next song is called Falling, off of the same album, Fine Line 2019 album. Can't believe 2019 was 4 years ago. Can anyone believe that? That doesn't make any sense to me. Anyway, Falling, this one's longer than the other ones. Love to see it. I'm a fan of longer songs. Oh, okay. It's mellow so far. Nice strings in the background. A lot of reverb. Nice piano. You're in your bed.
You're not here.
No, I'm in my chair. Thank you very much.
I can't take it back. I can't unpack the baggage left.
All right, we got some regretful lyrics.
What am I now?
All right. His voice is very good in upper registers when he's like, almost sounds like he's struggling sometimes, which I just think is cool. Those harmonies are good. Alright, so it's emotional the whole way. I wonder if it's gonna explode in the end or if it's gonna keep right in the chill wave. It's cool either way. Definitely gives me like 2012 One Direction vibes, you know? Which makes sense because he was in it, but even the lyrics, I feel like, are kind of like One Direction, too. All right. Long, high note. That's good. Impressive. I want to be able to do that. That sounds fun.
What am I now? What am I now? What if you're someone I just want to run? I'm falling again. I'm falling again. I'm falling.
Ooh, that run. That was good.
Cool. That's a good ending. I like that. All right. So a basic piano ballad like every pop star needs. Yeah, that was pretty good. The vocals are good. I feel like with most of these piano ballads, not just this song, but like songs in that direction, which are like mostly piano and just vocals, I feel like they're never really interesting enough. I guess it's more about the kind of emotional value. That was pretty decent. I like the strings with the reverb in the background and the occasional synths here and there, which are cool. Piano playing was nice. Harmonies are very good. So the next one is Sign of the Times, which is even longer. It's almost a 6 minute song. So I don't know what to expect from here. That's from an even older album. Again, has over 1 billion streams. Absolutely bonkers. more piano. Is it also going to be a ballad? We'll see. Hope you're wearing your best clothes. I'm really not. I'm wearing a wrinkled shirt. You can't bribe the door on your way to the sky. All right. You look pretty good down here. Down here? What does that mean? All right. Got some harmonies. I like the falsetto. That's really good. Got some synths creeping in as well. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Okay, yeah. That's how you do a ballad. Those guitar tones are almost country. It's pretty cool. Like the halftime drums, that's fun. Mixing's good. What was that? So my camera died in the middle of the song and it's been like 20 minutes, but let's just get back into it. Let's just keep going. Sorry about the interruption. Please leave a like. I really like the falsetto. There's a little bit of delay on the drums, which is cool. Oh, I love that tom fill. That's cool. Back to this part. The guitar on the left. That's fun. Oh, yeah. Oh, that triplet fill. Yes. It's all I want. Oh, this part is great. Yes! Oh, the triplets. Yeah! That's so high! This is really good. Yeah! Yes! That was so good. I love that. I love big power ballads. They're so good. Whew, I'm like sweating. That was incredible. That like bridge before the final chorus is crazy. The tom fills, the drums, oh my goodness. That was a fantastic song. I really, really like that one. And that first chorus when all the instruments came in after just being piano for a bit, that was nice too. I like that a lot. Love when songs do that. That one was definitely my favorite. I really, really like that one. That was great. So we're on to the last song. We're gonna do a Matilda, which is also off of his newest album, Matilda. Let's go. Okay. Some impressive acoustic guitar playing. Those harmonics are cool. I love when guitarists incorporate that in their playing. It's fun. Nothing but the way that you harmonies, always nice. Until now. So you tie up your hair and you smile like it's no big deal. You can let it go. Oh, that was nice. The bring. You can believe in and grow now. This melody is almost a bit ominous, and the harmonies, it's quite interesting. Doing it on your own. Oh, that's abrupt. Got some piano. It's a cool change up though. The harmonies with the piano fits really well. Oh, that's a nice chord. I like that. Cool. All All right, that was a nice ballad. Not too much to say about it. The guitar playing was good. I like the harmonics that were in that one. The switch up to the piano was very abrupt, but it was cool. The harmonies are really good as always. But I feel like there wasn't too much to this one, at least not after listening to Sign of the Times, which was so incredible. There were a lot more ballads on here than I was expecting, but I guess people like their sad boy music. Well, that was pretty fun. Sign of the Times is absolutely incredible. Adore You was really, really fun too. Those two are definitely my favorites. But man, Sign of the Times got me emotional. Like, that made me feel a lot of feelings. That was really good. I did not expect that from a Harry Styles song, of all things. Like a rockin' power ballad. That was really, really good. And Adore You is just a funky jam. I really love that one too. And then the rest, yeah, they're all right. That was Harry Styles. Kind of embarrassing that my camera died in the middle there. But if you enjoyed this video, then make sure to check out my last video. That one's also really, really fun. And I'll see you next time.
Let's go. Let's go. All right. Yes. Let's go. Wahoo!